Warning to the West, Vladimir Putin test launches terrifying 4,000 miles per hour invincible Satan missile. The weapon emerged from an underground silo, paused as if hovering above the ground, and then sped away in a cloud of white smoke. Vladimir Putin today answered his Western critics by demonstrating a fearsome test firing of Russia's new SAMR intercontinental ballistic missile, dubbed Satan's missile. Footage of the invincible 4,000 miles per hour hypersonic weapon shows as emerging from an underground silo and pausing as if hovering above the ground. It then speeds away in a cloud of white smoke from the snow-covered Plesetsk spaceport in northern Russia. The launch comes amid the greatest tension between Russia and the West since the end of the Cold War, with tit-for-tat diplomatic expulsions over the poisoning of Sergei and Yulia Skripal in Britain. Britain has blamed the nerve agent attack, which left the father and daughter fighting for their on Russia, but Putin has denied it had any involvement. The new launch is shown on a 23-second video from the Russian Defense Ministry. The ICBM was fired for the second time since tests began last December, say Moscow officials. This new test at the Plesetsk spaceport confirmed its characteristics during the pre-launch and initial flight phases, the ministry said in a statement published in its Krasnaya Zvezda, Red Star, newspaper. Putin said during his annual State of the Nation parliamentary address this month that Russia had begun actively testing the SAMR, known to NATO as the SSX-32 Snowflake. It is expected to go operational in 2021 with the Vyazar-based Strategic Missile Force Division. In order to intercept a SAMR, at least 500 American ABM missiles would be needed, according to Viktor Bondarev, chairman of Russian Senate's Defense and Security Committee and until recently commander of the country's aerospace forces. That is the conclusion of Western experts, he claimed. After Putin boasted about the SAMR, Western experts had expressed skepticism on how close Moscow was to operational use. But U.S. officials have sounded a growing alarm about the potential threat from hypersonic weapons, those that can travel at 5 times the speed of sound or more. The launch comes less than a month after Yulia and her ex-spy father Sergei were left fighting for their lives after they were poisoned with deadly nerve agent Novichok in Salisbury. Although it was feared they could never recover, but Dr. Christine Blanchard, medical director for Salisbury District Hospital, said yesterday that Yulia's condition had improved. Sources later told the BBC that she had recovered at such a rapid speed that she had woken from a coma. In her first public statement, Mr. Skripal's cousin Natalia, 65, said today from her home in Siberia, to say, "We were happy to hear of Yulia's improvement would be the greatest understatement." They were overjoyed by the Salisbury Hospital announcement. The condition of ex-MI6 informant Mr. Skripal, 66, remains critical following the Novichok attack on March 4. Russia denies any role in their poisoning. But Britain, major EU countries and the US have expelled Russian diplomats after Theresa May insisted Moscow was behind the Novichok attack in Salisbury. Police now believe the pair were poisoned by the deadly agent at Sergei Skripal's front door. Last October, Putin's defense ministry unveiled two new RS-28 SAMR super nukes. The 100-ton weapons, which could enter service as early as 2019, will make the bombs dropped on Japan look like pop guns, experts have said. Russia claimed the missiles can beat any defenses as it seeks to replace its arsenal of SS-18 Satan weapons. The Satan II missile was displayed during a Victory Day parade in May, and test firings have been delayed several times due to problems with the missile itself and silo.